Now here it's the Pashupati seal, a steatite steel seal discovered at Mohenjo-daro depicts a human figure or a deity sitting cross-legged. The figure referred to as Pashupati wears a three-horned headgear and is surrounded by animals, an elephant, a tiger and three on the left side of the figure, while a rhinoceros and a buffalo are seen on the right side. Two antelopes are also shown below the seat of the figure. So it's important that you remember Pashupati seal has been found in Mohenjo-daro, right? This is the Pashupati seal. Okay, and this is the unicorn seal that we have discussed earlier. Bronze figures. The Harappan civilization saw a wide-scale practice of bronze casting. The bronze statues were made using lost wax technique or cirque perdue. In this technique, wax figures, this is important because it's one of the important figurine that has been found in Mohenjo-daro. The dancing girl has also been made by using this lost wax technique. First coated with clay and allowed to dry. The clay coated figures are then heated, allowing the wax inside to melt. The wax is then poured out through a tiny hole and the liquid metal is poured inside the hollow mold. After the metal has cooled down and solidified, the clay coat is removed and a metal figure of the same shape as the wax figure is obtained. Even now, the same technique is practiced in many parts of the country. See, the bronze dancing girl of Mohenjo-daro, bronze bull of Kalibangan are examples. The dancing girl is the world's oldest bronze sculpture found in Mohenjo-daro. This 4-inch figure depicts a naked girl wearing only ornaments, which include bangles in the left arm and an amulet and bracelet on right arm. She stands in a tribhanga dancing position. This is the tribhanga dancing position with right hand on her hip. Now, seeing the terracotta. Terracotta refers to the use of fire-baked clay for making sculptures. Composed of bronze figures, the terracotta sculptures are less in number and crude in shape and form. They are made using pinching method. Pinching method is like molding with your hands, molding clay with your hands, and have been found mostly in the sites of Gujarat and Kalibangan. Terracotta was generally used to make toys, animal figures, miniature carts and wheels, etc. Mother goddess is the example of the terracotta. The mother goddess figure have been found in many Indus sites, which highlights its importance. It is crude figure with standing female adorned with necklaces hanging over prominent breasts. She wears a loincloth and a girdle. She also wears fan-shaped headgear. The facial features are also shown very crudely and lack fineness. She was probably worshipped for prosperity. She might also have been a goddess of fertility. This is all, it's just probability they are speaking. It's just probability because we have not yet deciphered the script. It's just the archaeologists have guessed that these figures might have been used for such worship. Now going to pottery. The potteries found at excavation sites can be broadly classified into two kinds: plain pottery and painted pottery. The painted pottery is also known as red and black pottery, as it is used red color to paint the background and glossy black paint was used to draw designs. Red and black pottery. Trees, birds, animal figures, geometrical patterns were the recurring themes of the painting. Most of the potteries that have been found are fine wheel made, was with a very few being handmade. Some examples of polychrome pottery have also been found, though very rare. See, these are the polychrome pottery are very rare. Wheel made wares are popular. The potteries were used for three main purposes. Plain pottery was used for household purpose, mainly storage of grains and water. Miniature vessels, generally less than half an inch in size, were used as decorative purposes. These are used for the household, these for small ones for decorative. Okay, small ones for decorative. Some of the potteries were perforated. Perforated means they have holes. If this is a pot, they have holes with a large hole at the bottom and small holes across the sides. They might have been used for straining liquor. Okay, yeah, see, this is the perforated pottery and this is the black one. Now going to the ornaments, the Harappans used a large variety of metals, from precious metals and gemstones to bones and even baked clay, to make ornaments. Both men and women wore ornaments like necklaces, fillets, armlets and finger rings. Okay, see, these are the examples of ornaments that have been worn by people back then, various ornaments found in Harappan civilization.